Hello everyone. So let's see what is consolidation by Sandbrain. I am Chitra CJ taking you ground improvement. So consolidation. What is consolidation? It is a process by which soil decreases its volume by expelling the water from its pores. So when we apply gradual load over the soil mass, started to expel the water that is stored inside the pores without replacing it with the air, thereby reducing its entire volume. So it is the principle of carbon surcharge. It occurs when stress is applied to the soil that causes the soil particles to pack together, thereby reducing its volume. So sand rain, it is a simple process in which we are inserting a column of at least 10 inch into the ground that is to be consolidated. The column is then refilled with sand and connected to a free draining blanket of granular soil. In the figure you can see that we are constructing vertical sand drains into the soil, and over this we are providing a sand blanket for the proper drainage, and above this we are adding a surcharge of embankment. So once this load is applied over this, that is surcharge is applied over the sand blanket, it started to consolidate the soil and the expelled pores or expelled water will go to the sand drain. Let's see the construction of sand drain. A sand layer of 50 to 60 cm thickness is initially laid over the soft soil that not only served as a drainage layer, or it also acts as a platform for the construction to happen. And the sand layer also acts as a filter in between the embankment and the subsoil. The embankment is built to some height above the sand layer to facilitate partial consolidation of the subsoil. This facilitates the subsoil to gain some shear strength to support and sustain the sand layer. The full height of the embankment is not constructed in single stage because of the soft soil will not have the sufficient strength to support all the embankment. After the embankment is constructed to a some height, the sand drains are installed. A circular casing or hollow steel mandrel of about 25 cm internal diameter and 6 meter height is driven into the soft soil to the required depth for the construction of this column. And the soil in the mandrel is removed and the hole is backfilled with the clean sand. The mandrel is then removed. The embankment is then constructed up to the full height in stages. After allowing sufficient time for consolidation to complete, the required structure such as pavement, airport or oil storage tank etc. is constructed. The arrangement or the layout of the sand drains can be either in square or triangular platform. The figure shows the sand drain installed below an embankment. The arrow shows the passage of water from the pores to the sand drain. And here you can see the structure is being constructed over the embankment. Next is need for using sand drain. Structures constructed over highly compressible soil such as clay will have very high consolidation settlement. So, pile foundation may not be suitable for these types of clay, like heavy settlement will occur, and the surface of such soil deposit is so soft that it's difficult to use heavy construction equipment also. So, before the starting of the construction, we need to consolidate the soil so that it increases its capacity to hold the heavy load that is coming on it. The permeability of the clay is very low, so the consolidation time is very high. So to reduce the consolidation time, we are using the sand drain. The water that is expelling from the pores will directly go to this vertical drain so that the traveling time of the water can be reduced. So the principle of the sand drain is to provide additional vertical drainage spaces in the form of cylindrical holes. Thus, the squeezed water from the pores due to consolidation can flow faster to the sand drain. Vertical sand drains are used as an effective technique for construction of structures such as oil, gas storage, airport, seaport, harbor works, etc. In the figure, you can see that the passage of water from the slate to the vertical drain, the arrow shows the passage of water, and once it reaches the drain, it goes up through the drainage blanket that we have provided over it and can be expelled out. Advantages of sand drains. The following are the advantages of using sand drains. The provision of sand drains allows drainage of pore water in radial direction in addition to the drainage in vertical direction. Second one is, since the permeability of soil in the horizontal direction is more, the consolidation rate becomes considerably faster. And the third is, with faster consolidation rate, the soil gains the shear strength rapidly, thereby reducing the project cost. And the fourth is, the long-term stability of the structure is also increased significantly as the potential settlements are completely acquired during the construction. And the fifth is, the sand drains avoid potential problems during the construction in soft, compressible soil. Thank you.